What's up, people? You know who it is, LA Dub here, and I just wanted to say Sean will be back to the podcast soon. He's just been really, really busy, and I've been on my grind. You know, we got to keep the show moving. So for this episode, I'm actually outside the studio, but I had a conversation with someone, and I wanted to tune everyone in because we're getting ready for a huge, huge event. So without further ado, here's the podcast.
Welcome to the Millionaire Car Salesman Podcast, the number one resource for automotive sales professionals, managers, and owners to learn how to make money, accumulate wealth, and to all out ball out in the auto industry. And now, your hosts, Sean V. Bradley and L.A. Williams.
Hey, what's going on, everybody? This is L.A. Williams, and I'm here live on the Millionaire Car Salesman Podcast. And man, we are super duper excited. Why? Because we are 103 days away from the Internet Sales 20 Group, number 13 in Houston, right? So we're going to be rocking and rolling. And I don't even know if we, I know it's actually the 13th one, but we're just going to kind of break away from that, man. It's the IS20G, right? That's what it's all about. And so what I'm doing now is I'm bringing forth the speakers, the people who will be presenting to you, because I know all my listeners going to be at the Internet Sales 20 Group. I ain't even got to ask that question. But we're going to be talking to the people who are going to be speaking to you and who will be connecting with and interacting with at the Internet Sales 20 Group. And today's guest, man, is my main man. Listen, this guy is absolutely phenomenal. This gentleman is the marketing director of a 10 rooftop dealer group. So without further ado, let me bring to the microphone my main man, Mr. Jason Caliri. What's up, Jason?
Hi, LA. How are you?
I'm super excited, man. This is going to be a great conversation we get ready to have today.
It's going to be a great conversation, and then the ISG20 is going to be simply amazing.
Absolutely. I'm super excited. Like I said, we're 103 days away. So, first of all, you know, marketing is such a huge deal in business, period, right? It's just one of those things, right? We know we always talk about sales, you know, we hear accounting, we hear, you know, research and development, but marketing, it's something that is, it's a special piece of business. So I know that's where your background is in marketing. Am I right?
Absolutely.
Tell us how this whole marketing thing got started for you.
So before I entered the automotive industry, I spent 15 years in media and traditionally in traditional terrestrial radio. I was in marketing for a couple companies like CBS Radio, Clear Channel Radio before it became iHeartRadio, what everybody knows today, Pyramid, you know, some of the smaller companies that were buying stations and starting to form all these big conglomerate groups that are out there today. Mm-hmm. So I spent some time there and then transitioned into the automotive world. And, you know, it's been pleasant, you know, past 10 years in the automotive world and in a little town called Rochester in upstate New York. You know, I laugh because, you know, Rochester's really not that little, but it's not a big city, but it's medium-sized. That's where I'm at now. And that's awesome, how we got connected.
100%, man. That's why I was, like, struggling thinking of the town that it was that we met in. I'm like, it wasn't Rochester. What's the name of the town?
It was beautiful Canandaigua, New York, right off of Canandaigua Lake, down in the Finger Lakes.
I didn't want to mess up how I said it, so.
Oh, it's okay. It's okay. Cool. A couple weeks ago, Luke Bryan was in town, and he just simply said Canandaigua. So everybody just pointed and started laughing about that. So
cool, man, cool. All right, so you get into automotive. First of all, most people don't wake up and say, Mommy, Daddy, I want to sell cars. I want to be in the automotive industry. What had you make that transition?
So a very good friend of mine who's still in radio today, up here in Rochester, was working with this group for a good 4 or 5 years. And he said, he called me one day and he says, look, I want to have you sit down with some people. I need you to talk to them. And only you can really, he goes, figure it out. Some of the things that they're doing are successful. Some of the things, you know, are falling flat on their face. But, you know, I think you could actually bridge that gap and take it to the next level. So I said, okay. I said, you know, we talked about it. I said, automotive. I said, you know, from years in media, when you talk automotive, and this is coming from the media side. This is not coming from the automotive side. You have, you know, television, radio, print, you know, all that, you know, we're going back, you know, 20 years. Mm-hmm. When you're talking automotive to them, they're like, okay, it's the car dealers that do the sales on the weekends, and they're open more than furniture stores, and every week is a sale, and every day is a push, every day is a grind, and no matter what we do, most times things just don't pan out. Then they go away for a couple months, and then they come back and they've got another sale, and they want to sell 75 cars in one day, and you know they're going to pull out all the stops, and they want you to do a radio remote at the dealership. And sitting back on that side of the desk, you're sitting there going, well, we just went through this 3 months ago and it really didn't pan out. So how is this time going to be any different? Mm-hmm. And that's a crutch and across everybody bears across the country. Radio is a phenomenal medium, okay? I speaking from experience, you can touch more people a week by turning on the radio in your car, in your home. You can listen to it now because the technology is there and the technology has changed where you can just talk to Google, you can talk to Alexa, they can pull up your favorite stations, you know, you can podcast everything. You know, the radio stations themselves have built themselves into their own empires, you know, through the same channels that you're doing it, you know, podcasting, you know, the AI-based, you know, apps and, you know, webcasting and simulcasting and satellite. It's really the form that never changes. But it does change for the masses. Mm-hmm. So the guy behind the board pushing the buttons, or the gal behind the board pushing the buttons, talking to you directly. So sitting there, I'm having this phone call with my friend, and I said, well, if they're not willing to change their way of thinking, it's never going to work. And he's like, just talk to him. I said, okay. So I went in and I met with, you know, the GM and the team at the one rooftop. And, you know, I took the position, you know, I was just selling cars at one of the Nissan stores. And I had a couple of meetings with one of the owners and we started talking about things. And he recently came back from one of his NADA trips. And he says, you know what? Everything you and I talked about in that meeting was 100% correct because they just talked about it at NADA. Mm. But the problem with that is I've got two partners and I don't know if they want to shift the thought process and how to manipulate and how to broaden that reach and that horizon doing it this way. And I said, wow, that's a conversation you traditionally have to have with them. So we had the talk and, you know, they said, you know what, start with just that store. And we said, okay. So I started working on that store with the agency that was on board, for years. They had the same advertising agency. And we started doing some little things and making some changes. And the owner himself came into the store and we took that rooftop from, you know, 50 to 60 new cars a month and about 30 to 40 used cars a month. And we changed it in 7.5 months to being number one in the district with putting 150 to 165 cars out a month new and another 40 to 50 cars used. Mm. And it was just basically the intent, the focus. He focused on the inventory and, you know, what was going on in-house, and I focused on everything outside the four walls of the store, along with the agency.
All right, so we definitely got to talk about that. That's huge. So we took a store, you know, from making, you know, 100,000-150,000 a month to 400,000-500,000 a month. I mean, that's, you know, that's a huge difference, right? You made that a $6 million a year store. So
absolutely.
Yeah. So talk about what are these thought process changes that need to happen? If I'm, you know, even still, you know, like you said, 20 years later, 2019, I'm still thinking the old quote unquote way. What are the thought processes? What are the thinking changes I need to make to do what they did? That was amazing.
So, thank you. So LA, when you're talking radio and you're talking 20 years ago, you didn't have the web platforms that you have today. You didn't have the AI-assisted apps between Google and Amazon and all that. None of that existed. You just started kicking in with social media. People were afraid of it. People didn't understand it. And your manufacturers and your OEMs, they had no idea what the trend was going to look like. What we did that was different, when you buy like your radio time, no matter what radio group you're talking about, you buy your spots, you run your spots, you have your DJs or your production people produce the spots, and then they run. And then you just throw everything up in the air and let's see what sticks, what comes in. Okay, obviously you want to push more towards the end of the month because you have to hit those numbers, but how are you going to send that consistent message? The way I took it was, who are you trying to reach? Because if I've got to push some serious trucks out the door, okay, and I've got a separate truck number I have to hit a month, there is no way, I'm not saying that it wouldn't help, but there is no way I'm putting 90% of my budget into an easy listening station. Because I'm never going to hit that truck number doing that.
Right.
You're going to focus for that truck number, and you're going to market that truck number and your budget behind it for the intender that you want to purchase that truck. You're going to go on that country music station. You're going to go on that rock station, that heritage rock station in your market. You're going to have those DJs, you know, back in the day, we've got to remember, they were all DJs. They were not personalities. Mm-hmm. You want the DJs to push the product. But then you got to take a step. You got to take it a step further and say, "How do I get these DJs to talk more about me rather than just the 10 spots that are going to run during that week?" How do you do that? What you do is you start creating the content with them and the radio group off the air. Okay, are you following me?
Yep.
So basically, if you have a loaner program or a rental program, you're going to put them in a truck. You're going to do social media videos with the DJs. Have them do your walkarounds. Mm-hmm. You're going to have them show you how much those vehicles can tow. You're going to post those videos on social media in today's day and age. Because guess what? You're going to hit your audience. It's going to be on your social media. It's going to be on their personal social media because, you know, it's a day in the life of them. Mm-hmm. And then it's going to be on the station page's social media. So you're going to hit three separate audiences based on the intender of what you want to sell.
What you just said makes sense to me now because I understand a social media influencer. I understand from the music industry the idea of a celebrity, you know, doing this walk around because, you know, hey, listen, Beyonce, you know, could drive that truck. I could drive that truck. You know what I'm saying? The whole bandwagon thought process that we learned in, you know, sixth grade marketing, you know, that whole thing. So, sure. So all of that is awesome. And you're absolutely right. Most people, even though we know that's what works because it's what works on us, we never really think about that's how we should approach it. But you're absolutely right. So in today's age, right, basically what I hear you saying is, hey, you know, get yourself an influencer, right? Somebody who can actually demonstrate the product for you. Through their demonstration of it, they'll fall in love with it. And then because they're in love with it, the people who they trust, their fan base, things like that, are going to fall in love with it, or are more likely to fall in love with it and purchase your product. Is that correct?
That's absolutely correct. Now you got to take this two ways. You are going to sit there and say, okay, I'm also going to run the risk that everybody on the planet doesn't like this person. I have to assume that.
Okay.
Okay. Just like you look at your Google reviews and yes, you are not going to please everyone. Mm-hmm. Okay. But when they comment and they post on that person's station page or personal page about what they like, okay, versus what you're demoing, it's creating conversation. And it's giving you the ability to have a more in-depth conversation and absolutely 100% educate the consumer even further. all of that product knowledge that your certified sales and leasing consultant downstairs sitting at the desk waiting for that customer to walk in the door, and you're creating an extension of your sales department with these influencers and these endorsers. And you do that for every single demo and model of every vehicle on your lot. I used, myself personally, I used the rule of four. Top four best-selling models that, number one, the factory objectives you've got to hit, and personally, what you want to showcase out of your store.
That's good.
And then you match up those influencers via those actuators and demo that way. Listen, LA, you and I have been around town, around this country. You travel every single week.
Yep.
How many times do you go into a store and you see someone in the Millionaire Club, or you yourself see somebody outside doing a video, doing a posting, and they're just sharing inventory to their Facebook page? You see it every day, right?
Yep.
Guess what? Everybody does it.
Yep.
So put yourself outside the box and make yourself known and brand yourself to something different. Be the resource to the people, and this is going in more to the social media, and I'll broaden this at ISG20. When you're a sales rep at that store, okay, do you have bottled water at your desk? In a fridge or chilled, ready for a customer to come in? They come in with a couple of kids. Do you go to Walmart every week, throw $10 down, buy 10 Matchbox cars or Hot Wheels cars, keep them in your desk, or some keychains and stuff for the girls, or Polly Pockets or anything that you can put in your desk? That way the kids are sitting there, they're going to be focusing on, wow, you just gave them a present, and that way mom and dad, or the family members can sit there and learn along with you. Is that happening? Because everybody's sharing inventory to social media. Who sees it? Your friends. How are you going to hit the masses unless you boost a post?
Yeah, they definitely don't understand the algorithms of social media and how that stuff works and things like that. So,
correct. I would rather myself, if I'm a sales guy downstairs or a sales gal downstairs at one of my stores, I tell my guys all the time, get on the manufacturer's social media pages or go on their YouTube page and pull some qualitative research on the vehicles that you're selling. Because 3 months down the road, after you sold that car, the customer's driving down the road and their Bluetooth disconnects. Where are they going to go to learn how to do it real quick if they're on the fly and they're on the road?
It's going to be a challenge.
They're not going to call the dealership and say, hey, or they're going to call the service provider, hey, my Bluetooth just disconnected. If they see it on the salesperson's social media feed, how to reconnect your Bluetooth in case it disconnects, they're going to remember that.
Mm-hmm.
What is, for the Hyundai listener, what is Blue Link? You have to have so many Blue Link registrations as a dealer for every vehicle that you sell per month. Nobody's explaining what Blue Link is. The factory does a fantastic What Is series video, but nobody, in the trenches, meeting with the customers, are sharing that information.
Mm-hmm.
You look in the Chrysler world, it's the same thing with Uconnect. They all have their own platforms. Years ago, LA, we can go back 10, 12 years, when Ford debuted the Sync system, that exploded in the marketplace. Did it or did it not? All across the country.
Absolutely, 100%.
And how many times did Ford tell the dealers you need to have 2 sync classes a month where you invite all of the people that purchase vehicles and you train them how to do it? To this day, I know Ford dealers that still have that class two to four times a week. Number one, the salespeople teach it, or the technology expert in the dealership teaches it. It keeps you up to date on your product knowledge, but it gives you content that you can post yourself.
Mm-hmm.
We're not reinventing the wheel. We are using the tools that are at our disposal.
Listen, you are so blessing the audience right now. So, because that's excellent.
So, I hope. I mean, there's a lot of other stuff that I'm going to be covering. You know, this is just the tip of the iceberg. But, you know, when you talk about what are you doing in your community? Everybody does golf tournaments. Everybody does hole-in-one tournaments. You know, for you know, nonprofit, you know, hole-in-ones. How many of you can actually sit there that listen to this and know for a fact all of the money that you donate stays local in your community, helping your issues in your town? Let's face it, man, I've been saying this for years. We all have children. Okay, most of us, I should say, have children. We're all our kids are on the same soccer teams together. They're all on the same lacrosse teams. They're all playing Little League together. Okay, you need to become a resource when you walk outside that door for those community organizations as well.
Mm-hmm.
If you can't do it personally, or if your dealer group is making the decision to help, find organizations to say, hey, these guys need some help. What do you think about this? It may be as simple as if they're doing a silent auction for a charity event and your dealer group or your dealer principal throws out 5 free oil changes to put in a silent auction basket. Mm-hmm. Guess what? When they take and get those free oil changes, guess what happens, LA? And nobody thinks about this. So, they're going to come in, they're going to redeem their free oil change. What's the service advisor's job?
Gotta convert.
Upsell, right?
Yeah.
So that person's going to get the free oil change. Hey, folks, by the way, your vehicle just went through a, you know, 104-point multi-point inspection. We noticed, we did your oil change, but we also noticed that your brake pads seem to get, you know, a little bit of wear. Now, if you'd like, we can replace those for you. If you'd like to pass, you could do that as well. How many people do you think replace the brake pads? Let's say out of 10.
Let's say even if half did it.
If half did it, you just put that money to the store's bottom line for nothing. It cost you nothing but the printing of the actual certificate to do that.
Again, man, you're really the blessing, folks. Now, how about this? Can you talk a little bit about marketing from a personal perspective? Because as millionaire car salesmen, listeners, I've got, you know, dealer principals, I've got general managers, but I also have individual salespeople who want to get their marketing tighter. So how would you coach a individual salesperson to tighten up their marketing?
So an individual salesperson, you've got to look at it differently. You work for the dealer, yes. You also work for yourself.
Yep.
Okay. Do you betray that dealer that gives you the desk, that gives you the phone, that gives you the computer, that gives you the ability to completely and continuously up your game, number one, financially, and number two, your own brand?
Better not.
Okay. Don't betray him, okay? You don't want to be that guy that's going to sell at 4 or 5 different mom and pop shops, plus you're going to be at the regular store. You can't do that because all of the money and the focus that dealer principal is putting into you because of their belief in you, okay, your job is to sell cars.
Mm-hmm.
So whatever that dealer group is doing and whatever that dealer principal is doing, you get behind them 100%. Because guess what? They're going to take you to the next level with their customers. Everybody says, well, they're my customers. No, they're not. They're the dealer principal's customers. They're that store's customers. You facilitate the end result as the car salesman. I firmly believe that. And guess what? You build yourself and your brand up while doing it. So you become the actual resource for that couple, for that family, 5 years down the road. We have folks in our dealer group, you know, with all 10 stores, we have folks that have been here over 25 years in the same position. They refuse promotions because they love and they are so passionate in what they do, and they love giving back, and they love helping their friends, their neighbors, and their families out. They don't take an up when they walk through the door.
Mm-hmm.
They have that base of business, and their follow-up is so dialed in, they know when the programs come out, if there's a pull ahead, they know who exactly can qualify for it,
mm-hmm.
and they turn that person around in the first 10 days of the month. Because we all know the slowest part of the car dealerships are the first 10 days of the month. And then you throw a month in like July when the incentives, because of the July 4th holiday, don't come out till the 10th or 12th, and your marketing team is trying to furiously get everything ready and up and running by the 13th.
This is good stuff, man. So, and the crazy thing is,
you're laughing because I know on your side of things, when you're on the phone and you're in these BDCs and you're trying to make all those contacts and you're trying to make those touches, the struggle is the first 10 days of the month.
Yeah, absolutely.
Especially when you're talking, LA, and you and I both know a 90-day sales cycle.
Man, you're on fire. I'm telling you, you're giving them that heat. And see, the crazy thing is that you're actually talking about some of the most successful people in the industry, the number one and number two salespeople, talking about Ali Reyna, right? You're talking about the Frank Crinitis. They are exactly the person that you just described, right? The person
absolutely.
That, man, I'm telling you, on it. That's exactly what they say. And so if we want to be millionaire car salesmen, right, it may not be that you want to move up and take the manager position. That just may not be your path. Right? It may not be your path to millions. Some people do want to move into management and, you know, sales manager, GM, become a dealer, things like that. It's one path, but you can also do it from the front lines. And exactly who you just described, Jason, are the people who are really, really killing it in the industry. So there ain't no refuting that.
Thanks.
Awesome.
I mean, they're the industry leaders. They speak volumes when they speak. A lot of people, you know, think, well, that won't work for me. Yes, it will. The other thing, you know, if you look at historically dealers, dealer groups, and even as individuals, if we try something once and it doesn't work, you give up on it. If you try things twice, it doesn't work, you give up on it. You try things a third time, there's something there. You have to maintain consistency. You know, 20 years ago, when you want that, you know, you're in the sales meeting and the dealer principal comes in or your general manager walks in the door and says, guys, we got the radio station coming today. We're going to sell 70 cars. The incentives are the best. They're absolutely incredible. And, you know, you get all hyped up and you get pumped. The radio station shows up and all of a sudden 15 people walk in and you're like, holy cow, this is actually working. But then they go to the radio station tent. And they get the movie tickets. Now, remember, this is 20 years ago. Or they get the free samples of Snapple, and then they disappear. And wait a minute, where'd all those ups go? Mm-hmm. So that's a little term in the media world where people call those people prize pigs. Every single remote that you do, you get prize pigs at. You have to be able to see through it. You see them come in with that busted trade-in, hit them up before they even hit the prize tent. Mm-hmm. Talk to them about that trade, how you don't believe just by sight that may not pass inspection next year. Do you owe any money on it? What are your payments? Start the conversation. Don't jump in and sell.
Yeah.
Because they're going to be with blinders on because they need those movie tickets. Mm-hmm. Okay? Take that traditional look, you know, of what happened all those years ago and transform it to today's day and age. One thing that I love to do, I love to get, if I've got a Raider remote at one of my stores on a Saturday or something, there has to be a major call to action in today's day and age for the people to stop what they're doing, especially on a Saturday or on a Thursday, to head to that dealership. People are way too busy in today's day and age to think if you're just having a radio station there, people are going to show. Create an event around that event.
Yes.
And the event isn't going to be, well, we've got $199 on X model, and it's a sign and drive. You can drive it out, you know, express delivery. You can deliver it today. You can drive home in it today. That's not an event. You want to showcase something in the community. Tie it in together. If you have a local celebrity, if you have a child's organization or a children's organization that you can tie into your dealership, do it that way. How many of the dealer groups around the holiday times do toy drives? Do they partner up with somebody like Toys for Tots? And they just put the box in the showroom that Toys for Tots gets them, and they send them the Marines on Saturdays, you know, for 2 hours, and they just do the appearance, and then they leave and take the toys with them? Or do you do a full campaign? Mm-hmm. And you tie everybody into stuff like that? You know, we're talking September, October. I don't know, in my area, in September and October, when everybody's, you know, started back to school and things are, people are running, you can't go to Walmart on a Saturday in town without running into Boy Scouts. Mm-hmm. And they're trying to sell popcorn. You can't run around this town in March and April and go to Walmart and not get hit up by the Girl Scouts selling cookies. Why are they at Walmart? Invite them into your stores. Guess what?
Yeah, that's right.
Guess what, L.A.? They have social media, too.
Sure do.
Hey, folks, we're going to be at XYZ Motors from noon to 3 with cookies. It may be closer to the people that are on their social medias than Walmart.
100%. And see, you know, we know that they're going there because that's where the people are. Right. But then because especially with Girl Scouts and Boy Scouts, everyone wants to support them. So it's like they go there because that's where the people are. But then there's also going to be a percentage of the population that come there because that's where they are. Right. And then especially how the millennials and even next generation Z, you know, are when it comes to their social media and how we got, you know, to look 6 to 7 year olds, 16 year olds making $1 million because of the network that they've built. Man, I'm telling you, you on fire, Jason.
Then just look internally at your staff. Mm-hmm. As a dealer principal, know what your staff does. Number one, know your staff. You should be able to, you know, and this is one of the things I can say about our owner of our group. He can literally walk into the stores. He'll walk in the back door of the detail shop, never walks in the front door of sales, walks in the back door of the detail shop, and he'll walk around the shop to service, to parts, to detail, into the office, up through the cashiers, then finally the sales, and says hello to your employees. Know what your employees do for, you know, for you, number one. Number two, know what they do behind the scenes in their lives. Get involved with them because they're your biggest asset. If you could count right now in one of your, and I'm speaking to the dealer principals, if you can count in your store at this moment the employees that are in your store, how many organizations do they belong to and do they support locally? And are you as the dealer principal supporting those organizations?
Say it again.
You as a dealer principal, do you know all the organizations or most of the organizations that your employees support in their personal time? And do you, as a dealer principal, help support those organizations as well? One of the biggest things we do, LA, here is we teamed up with one of the local American Legions. And every year we present a concert. And we bring in, with the American Legion, 14 bands, all of which donate all of their time, energy, and the sound to do it and put the show on. And we do an entire day as a warrior benefit concert because we believe firmly those people want to fight for us, and we're going to do whatever it takes to fight for them and to thank them for their service. We've got referral programs across the whole group, all 10 stores, for your military and your former military, you know, incentives. Mm-hmm. In addition to us kicking in a little portion for every unit sold, but we actually give it right back to the veterans organizations around town. And I'll tell you, what a sight to see when you're able to put on a show like that. That's the stuff that you're touching people in your community. That's the stuff people remember that you did for them.
Excellent stuff. So, man, you are really giving the people lots of knowledge. And, man, like you said, we're just scratching the scratch, because when the Internet Sales 20 group happens in Houston, November 11th through the 13th, man, I know you're going to, man, you're going to really give them that that work. So I'm excited about that. So
wait till I start showing you some examples on stage of stuff that we've done that you could easily customize for your stores nationwide. If dealer principals and other marketing directors and digital media directors want to sit down and talk, we can talk about that and how to execute. But, you know, as a top level baseline of how you can actually change your world that you can, you live in your geographical area, we can talk about that all day.
Because you got to want it. That's the whole thing. Like, okay, we, you know, we're gonna give you a piece of it here on the podcast just to let you know that it exists. And then when you come to the Internet Sales 20 group, we're going to give you examples so that you can say, okay, hey, this is a priority for my store. But then, like you said, it's like, okay, now come to me personally and we can kind of work together and really dive deep into exactly what you got going on. And let's see if we can make a difference, man. That's what I'm talking about. So
I have no problem. You know, my email address is obviously is posted within the panel graphics. I have no problem people friending me on social media. No problem with people sending me and asking me questions, and if I can help, I would gladly do so.
Awesome. So, of course, we'll post a link to it here in the podcast show notes. So it's going to be beautiful. So talk about this, man, because like I said, you got a lot of knowledge. You've got a lot of experience, but what books do you recommend? Are there any particular books on marketing that maybe you've read that you recommend that people take a look at in order to get some of this knowledge directly on paper?
So in the past, I've done a lot of reading in the past. Mm-hmm. Okay. But what I really like to see from my forefront and how I educate and continuously keep myself on the trends, mm-hmm. is I belong to a lot of marketing and consulting groups, whether it be on LinkedIn, whether it be private groups in Facebook. A lot of it is trial and error with other marketing directors across the country. I've still got radio marketing contacts that, you know, we bounce ideas off of each other in closed, you know, closed threads. But as far as general books, you know, years ago, there was a series of books of Social Media is King. Okay, and we're talking, it was a long time ago, and it was one or two printings, and then it disappeared. You can find it some ways on Amazon. There's the keys to success in social media. There's keys to success in marketing yourself. Those are all little excerpts that I've written, you know, that are, you know, almost like, you know, ebooks, mm-hmm. that I have found. But really a lot of it is, you know, the networking aspect of it for myself.
Absolutely. Because that takes
relationships to me mean more than anything in the world.
Yeah. We're on the same page with that, because books are one thing, and I think books are amazing. However, you never want to be that box of books kind of guy. You want to actually go and get involved, right? Make the thing human, right? The word becomes flesh, right? And let's
flesh. Absolutely. You know, you can have an idea pop in your head at 3:00 in the morning. Happens to me all the time. 4:00 in the morning, you jump up out of bed and you grab your phone or you grab your tablet and you just jot yourself down a note, or you go into another room and, you know, LA, you know it as well as I do. Your wife wakes up, what are you doing?
Yeah. Okay.
It just hits you.
Yeah.
And, you know, it happened to me last week. You know, we had an event and I was thinking, and it's been driving me insane, how I can have another event like the success of the one that we had last week. And I spoke to a couple of people about it yesterday. Plans are being laid out. So I'm looking at launching something, you know, on August 10th. If you look anywhere in the world, something big is happening on August 10th in the entertainment industry, and I'm trying to tie in with that. I'm not going to say anything else because I don't want to give all the secrets away. I will talk about it and probably have examples on how much of a success or not a success it was, because I've had stuff fail. You got to be able to take the good with the bad.
That's it.
And I'll talk about that, you know, stuff at the ISG 20 as well.
Awesome. Awesome. Cool. Cool, man. Well, definitely looking forward to having that happen. And man, we'll, once we post this, right, it'll be posted on my YouTube channel, The Blind Phone Master. It'll be posted, you know, obviously Sean Bradley will post it. It'll be everywhere podcasts are listened to. But what I want to do is any of the social media places, go there and kind of leave some comments. And then Jason will come in and kind of let people know exactly what's happening from that perspective. Is that something you'd be willing to do, Jay?
Absolutely, absolutely. You know, I actually posted a couple things a couple weeks ago in the Millionaire Club. And I don't know if Sean told you about them or not, but one of the things that I posted was, and it's funny because you're thinking, why is this in a car salesman group and what does that have to do with me? And it was an article that I read on how Disney has completely changed the game with experimental or extensional marketing when they when they launched Star Wars Galaxy's Edge. And you read that article and you take the takeaway that I got from it is, as a salesman in today's day and age, what am I doing with all of the channels that I have available to me to be the success that Disney had with Star Wars Galaxy's Edge? How do I create that theater of the mind to tell people the buck stops with you? You to be that resource.
Excellent. So what I'm getting from this is that the number one way to train yourself in marketing is to be around marketers. The crazy thing is it's copycat, but because it's so individual, it's not copycat. It's like you can repurpose what people are doing and put your own spin on it, and that's how it becomes authentically you. And so I love that. So I just got a couple of other things I want to run by you because, again, you came from media. You entered into the automotive industry. What is it that you love about automotive? What keeps you here? You've been here for years. What is it that you love about the industry?
The people. It's the people. You will never find another industry out there where you have so many different personalities, but at the same time, so many people, so many of them are as down to earth as they are. People are real. You can have a real conversation with somebody and you can say, what do you do? Because in my head, when they're telling me, I'm coming up with ideas to multiply that times 100 to say, this is how I'm going to reach people next.
Excellent. That's what I'm talking about, man. So, wow, you are really, you know, giving some people, like I said, I'm saying it over and over and over again because you just keep giving them more and more heat. Like, you just keep turning up the temperature. It's like it was last weekend around here, 100 degrees. You know what I'm saying? You keep it.
Oh, yeah.
So just kind of give the folks a closing statement. Anything in particular that you want to say, that you want to talk about, you know, invite the people to the Internet Sales 20 group. Let them know what they're going to be getting from you and we'll close it out.
First of all, thank you. Thank you. You know, LA, this was fantastic. I thank you. Obviously, I thank Sean for the opportunity. I can't wait to meet everybody at ISG 20 in Houston. I think we're going to have a lot of fun. You're going to be able to see a lot of different things that you normally haven't seen or possibly could have seen, but now you could take a different stance on it to say, wow, I could really change this up and make it better. I could share with you some of the trials and tribulations that I've dealt with, because everything is in a success. As long as you believe in yourself, you'll be successful. And that's my biggest thing that I can't impose enough on people, is to believe in yourself and believe in what you are doing and how many people you are actually helping. Because you're selling that car over the, and the delivery is leaving and it's driving onto the main road in front of the store. With that sale that you just had, how many people did it affect? How many people did it satisfy and help? Really take that and look at yourself in the mirror and say, I've got this, I'm going to do this, and I'm going to be able to excel in this.
Wow. Amazing stuff, man. So listen, I always say you are the average of the five people who you spend the most time with. And the crazy thing is you ain't really spent that much time with us. You've been spending time with Jason Caliri and LA Williams. But listen, take it to the next level. Don't just spend 45 minutes, an hour, you know, even re-listening to this, man. Come spend 3 days with us, right, at the Internet Sales 20 Group in Houston. Go out there and be a millionaire car salesman. Thanks, everybody, for listening. Thanks for joining us, Jason. Appreciate you.
Thank you. Thanks, guys, for having me.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you like it, you love it, you want more of it, then don't wait for the next money show. Just go to BradleyOnDemand.com and take your career to the next level.
I took 100 visually impaired children that do a camp locally here. I took them all to the amusement park yesterday. And we do that twice a year during the month of July. And it just so happened yesterday was the day. So I was just cleaning up from that, getting back from that event. And Sean calls and he's like FaceTiming me. I'm like, what's up? He goes, we're doing the podcast tomorrow. I'll call you later. I'm like, okay.
That's excellent, man. And here's the thing, man. You can't tell me you take 100 visually impaired children somewhere and I not go. Come on, man. Like, you got to plug your boy in. You know what I'm saying? If anything, listen, I'm telling you, I'll be an example to them about what is possible for their lives, man. So if
I can be
assistance to you in any way, definitely, you know, reach out to me. Whether you got to FaceTime me, I don't know how beneficial it would be for them, but, you know, like, put me on a call. You know, let's hop on a Zoom, whatever I can do, and let's have them ask me some questions. Let's shoot, if I need to travel out there, let's get them to, let's connect, and let's just make it happen, man. I'd love to do something like that.
Absolutely. I will definitely. All right, definitely. Thanks, man. Good talking to you. And Justin said hello, by the way.
That's my man. Tell him I said hey.
I will. Thanks, LA.
Peace.